Hey, what's up everybody? Welcome back to my channel. Joshua Partugi here. So before we start today's video, I would like to give everyone a massive thank you, especially for those of you who already subscribed to this channel, because just a few days ago, this channel reached another milestone, that is 1,000 subscribers. That could only mean good things, because that means we can work together in influencing people around the globe in how they deliver value to their customers. I thank you for your trust and support to this channel, because your trust and support will motivate me to continuously deliver better and more reliable content, especially on Scrum. So let's start today's video. So in today's video, I would like to discuss about one of the most important aspects of Scrum. However, this aspect is oftentimes neglected by organizations implementing Scrum. And that most important aspect is the definition of done. Neglecting the definition of done is one of the reasons why we see a lot of failed Scrum implementations in the market. Not putting enough emphasis on technical excellence in the definition of done is one of the reasons why we see a lot of products with technical debts in the market. If I can summarize Scrum into a single line statement, it would be to continuously deliver a done increment that achieves the sprint goal every single sprint. So because of these problems we found in the industry, in today's video, I'm going to talk about the definition of done and the importance of done in Scrum. Many of my future videos is going to refer back to today's video, so make sure you don't go anywhere, stay on this video.
A lot of people think that the definition of done is the same as acceptance criteria. The acceptance criteria is the attribute of the product backlog item, while the definition of done is the attribute of the increment. Ensure that the acceptance criteria of every product backlog item is done is just one of the checklists in the definition of done. According to Scrum Guide, when the increment meets the definition of done, it means the increment is ready to be deployed to production environment. And of course, ensuring that every acceptance criteria is met is not enough to ensure the increment has production ready quality. Other checklists that needs to be in the definition of done to ensure production ready quality includes all levels of testing, such as, for example, unit testing, integration testing, functional testing, penetration testing, security testing, performance testing, etc.
A lot of people think that when their organization start to implement Scrum, they no longer need to write any documentations. This is a big fat myth. In Scrum, any documentations that's written should be valuable for the business and also for the Scrum team. Any valuable documentations that needs to be written should be part of the definition of done.
So every documentations that are considered valuable both by the business and by the Scrum team, such as for example, user guide, troubleshooting guide, release notes, system architecture, test case scenario, etc., should be in the definition of done.
Another big fat myth I've found in the market is, a lot of people think that Scrum doesn't care about any governance process. Financial institutions that are regulated by the government requires the governance process to be done. If governance process is required for the increment to be considered as done, then it should be part of the definition of done.
If governance process or audit results either from the government or any international standard body is required for the increment to be considered as production ready, then these items should be in the definition of done. As I said in the beginning of this video, there are a lot of crippling products in the market because of the definition of done does not include any technical excellence practices or any DevOps practices, such as, for example, unit test script with 90% test coverage, code review through pair programming or mob programming, automated acceptance test script, continuous integration, automated deployment script, automated provisioning script, etc. During sprint review, only sprint backlog items that meet all of the checkboxes in the definition of done that become part of the increment and discussed with the stakeholders. All of the sprint backlog items that do not meet all of the checkboxes in the definition of done goes back to the product backlog for the product owner to manage. All of the sprint backlog items that meet the definition of done can be released to production environment if the product owner wants to.
Just like how the product owner owns the product backlog, the development team owns the definition of done, because the development team is accountable for the high quality of the product. The development team continuously improves the definition of done, usually during sprint retrospective, to ensure that the quality of the product is continuously improving. So that is all from me today, folks. Thanks for watching today's video. I hope you found today's video helpful to help you improve the quality of your product and most importantly, to improve the level of your agility to deliver value to your customers. If you found today's video helpful, don't forget to smash that like button. And also, don't forget to share today's video to the world so more people can understand the importance of Done in Scrum. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel so that you won't miss any of my video in the future. See you until my next video. Bye.